like he has enough leg. Money. Jared Barker is on the money. Canada draws first blood. It's not a great service from Dunkley there. Scotland looks to find some space in the back. Nice kick there, quickly taken though. There's Aslan in a bit of trouble. Stanley's lost the ball, on goes the Scots. Chris Patterson with the try for Scotland. On a mistake there by Winston Stanley.
Scottish try scored by number 11.
First thrown over top, Nick Makowski in there. Here comes the snowman, Rod Snow from Newport, Wales, from St. John's, Newfoundland. Ball coming to Philip Murphy, Ontario player playing in France. And Philip drives hard for the line and gets over. That man has tremendous power, and it's very interesting. I said to Philip Murphy before the game, you are going to score a try today, son. You're going to score a try. And he'll be just excited about that.
Conversely,
Canada continues to answer back.
Jared Barker
here at T-Bird Stadium for Canada. Money in the bank again for Canada. 13-7. Canada leading here at T-Bird Stadium. Duncan Hodge with the restart, and I would say that Canada obviously happy with the way things have gone. We're going to head down to the sidelines for some half. It's through. You called it, Gary. 13-10 now for the home side over the visitors from Scotland.
Bring the score.
Few Scottish shirts. They move in. Try for Scotland.
Well, 38 minutes, Scotland has scored the go-ahead try. Al Sharon was in the sin bin. He's with the fourth official, and he'll sit out 10 minutes of this game, not including halftime.
Michael Blair with the try for Scotland in his debut. He scored a try last weekend in Markham. That one, from what I understand, was a long run. This one, a short one, but very nicely done there.
He's a talented young player. Here's the driving maul. Scotland stole the ball from Canada. They drive ahead, drive ahead. Ball's produced. Drive over, and I can't see it, but Mr. McHugh can. His hand goes up right away.
Rogers Sportsnet.
As we take a look at beautiful Stanley Park here in Vancouver, we're at Thunderbird Stadium, which is on the campus of the University of British Columbia. Halftime right now with Scotland ahead 15.
They changed their preparation. I figured this is why they call him Chainsaw, not because he cuts people down, but he cuts through people. I've got it now. And that's exactly what he did. That's what the Chainsaw did. He cut through people. Ball close to the line. It's an automatic play. They'll pick it up here. Three guys bind on the Scottish player and drive him over the line. That was just too easy.
Simon Taylor with the try for Scotland. Taylor's 12th cap with the penalty attempt. Barker bang on as he pulls Canada within a converted try. Nice to see Barker answer after missing that drop goal.
Well, Canada.
Back to Barker. Barker pins his ears back and goes forward. Picked up there by Banks. Canada moving on. Scotland in a bit of trouble here as Canada pushes for the line. Picked
John
up Teal there.
Goes, John Teal goes.
John Teal in.
Try, John
for
Teal.
Try. Canada. Very nicely done by John Teal, his second try for the Maple Leaf.
This is the old-time Canadian rugby smash and grab, pick it up, go straight ahead. The boy from White Rock, the boy from Semi, now professional bridge end, scores a try for Canada right at the post. Driving ahead, play started with Jared Barker. Pressure's on, Johnny Teal in the back. They missed the tackle. Scotland missed the tackle. He's not held. So he goes, touches the ball at the base of the post, which is a try. Here's a very close-up, John Teal.
Sheer determination here, Gary. Just wouldn't give up. Just kept going and going.
He went back and spoke to his high school this week to give them the story of Canada, his life. And I'm sure the Semi boys are here cheering on their hero, John Teal.
Barker converts.
More pressure on this young man in his fourth international.
Barker's boot. It's good. He's bang on the money again. Canada's taking the lead with just over 3 minutes to go. 26.
Second best thing I've seen today. Canada got possession.
Now watch the referee look at his watch. Here's advantage. I'm not sure if we won any advantage. I think we want
Williams to Barker. Barker just kicks it through to touch.
And
there's the final winner. History is made here at Thunderbird Stadium as Canada knocks off Scotland for the first time in an international test.
Well, Jared Barker, the hero with the last penalty, and he deserves every bit of these accolades. The crowd are on their feet, the boys are on their feet, and that's a great, it's great to be a part of this in any fashion, whether you're a supporter or a player. And these guys have done a great job. Congratulations.
Gareth Rees, the hero in Wales when we won in the Wells Stadium. Jared Barker, the hero here today at Thunderbird Stadium. There's only one country left to beat, and that's Ireland.
The tradition of good young Canadian kickers continue as Canada snaps a five-match losing streak. Excitement all on the field, and they really did make some good adjustments from last weekend to come take this game, Gareth.
Well, I think you've got to give credit to David Clark, the coach. He had faith in his team. He had faith in the wide game. He made the adjustments, and it worked out for him today. But those are the boys that win the game, David Clark will say. It's on the field. It's with the hearts. Yep. All the internationals that came here to watch us and watch their players, they've come through for them today. Look at the smiles on those faces.